My dad's a mechanic, so we have a lot of projects going on at home, and I've been able to learn how to properly use all sorts of power tools. I've learned how to weld so that I can help out at home. I've helped my dad build our whole animal enclosure with skills that I've learned in this class.
It's really cool to be able to take things and use your hands and make things. Because we're not only going to give you an idea of how to use a lot of different types of tools and equipment and provide you skills in a variety of trades, we're going to give you the opportunity to use your hands and do school outside of a textbook.
What I've enjoyed about this pathway is being able to learn things that I'm going to use later in life, like welding I'll need later, and like the different community skills and all the different leadership skills I've learned.
The thing that I like most about this pathway is you don't see a lot of girls in welding like outside of this class, and there's very few in this class, so I like being able to surprise people when I tell them I'm a girl that can weld.
It's fun being a female doing this stuff, just because sometimes people come in and go, wait, you're the shop teacher? Yeah, I'm the shop teacher. Everybody can do it. Let me teach you how to do it too.
Some skills I've learned in this pathway, definitely learning how to weld would be one. Learning how to use different power tools would be another one.
If I had to choose anyone to teach me and all of my friends how to weld, it'd be Miss Lindsay. She makes our class fun, she provides jokes, and if you ever need anything, she's there.
Our welding program, we have 5 booths inside that you can see probably behind me, and then we have 5 welding booths outside. We have 10 arc welders, 5 MIG welders, 2 TIG welders, and so the different welding processes, the students have an opportunity to learn. All students in Ag Mechanics 1 will learn the shielded metal arc welding process. It's important to me, though, that they learn how to successfully arc weld as we build upon the other welding processes.
So there's been times where I've needed to weld at home, and before I've taken a class, I didn't know how to weld, but now that I know a little bit about it, I've been able to weld at home now.
We have 2 TorchMate tables here. TorchMate is a product of Lincoln Electric, and what it does is it allows us to put pretty much any kind of picture we want into the computer, and if we can get it into the computer, we can cut it out of metal using a plasma torch to do that work for us. So the students are trained how to program the computer as well as run the table, because it's 2 separate pieces that they have to have mastery of to make the product happen.
Some of the skills I've learned in this pathway is learning how to weld, the different types of welds, how to perfect the welds, and then I learned how to use the TorchMate table, and it's just a fun class to be in.
The koi pond was a really fun project that students completed just last year. We worked with the Inland Koi Society, and so members of that organization worked with us and the students in the advanced ag mechanics class, a couple different groups of them, to build the filtration systems, to dig the pond down to the appropriate depth, to get the pond liner in, and all of the plumbing needed. So that's definitely a project that the students got an opportunity to take some of the skills that they're learning in class and apply it to something that's really outside of what we've ever done in the classroom setting before or in the shop setting before.
Kids should join this pathway because it's one of the best pathways to join, and it's super fun, and you get to learn skills that you'll might need in life, and you get to learn them in a fun way.
I honestly love what I do. I love working with kids. I love teaching them a skill, and there's always room. Even if you can't necessarily fit ag mechanics in 1 year, you could fit it in the next year, and get through as many classes as you can to gain skills that'll help you out in your future. Because as an adult, it would be good to know, you know, how to fix some general plumbing issues that might pop up in your household instead of paying a plumber a couple $100 to come out and fix it for you. Ultimately, hopefully, everything that we teach here, the kids can utilize either personally at home later, or they can use it to run some type of business.